for a non-interested ministry, about number one, and place of a vehicle, properties, master hand, federal, we've been in the ministry for a long time. A long time, and we're still here.
Amen. Praise God.
In Psalm 5, it says, give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Give heed to the voice of my cry, my King and my God. For to you I will pray. My voice you shall hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning I will direct it to you, and I will look up. For you are not a God who takes pleasure in wickedness, nor shall evil dwell with you. The boastful shall not stand in your sight. You hate all workers of iniquity. You shall destroy those who speak falsehood. The Lord abhors the bloodthirsty and deceitful man. But as for me, I will come into your house in the multitude of your mercy. In fear of you, I will worship towards your holy temple. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness because of my enemies. Make your way straight before my face. For there is no faithfulness in their mouth. Their inward part is destruction. Their throat is an open tomb. They flatter with their tongue. Pronounce them guilty, O God. Let them fall by their own counsels. Cast them out in the multitude of their transgressions, for they have rebelled against you. But let all those rejoice who put their trust in you. Let them even shout for joy, because you defend them. Let those also who love your name be joyful in you. For you, O Lord, will bless the righteous with favor.
Amen. Favor.
Favor. Amen. You will surround himself with a shield. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Lord.
Amen. And I have a testimony. Like I said, for the anniversary, we was like going from church to church, y'all. We was here, there, everywhere. And one church I was in, it was like, oh my God. It was unbelievable. And, you know, we left that church. And I wasn't going to church for a little minute. I was, you know, praying home and meditating and going fasting. And one Tuesday evening, before 7 o'clock, this person passed on the, like coming from sign, and like was going on, and I live right on the corner. And I heard a voice say, Calvin, like, you want to go to Bible study? And I'm like, yeah, let's go. What church? I was anxious, I wanted to get back in the church. So he said, Calvin. And I said, come on, let's go right now. So we came to the Bible study. And y'all, when I parked in the parking lot, number one, it's like something just came off of me, like a load was lifted off of me. When I got put my foot on the ground of that Lonnie Christian ministry, put one foot on the ground of the car, it's like, oh God. Everything that was on me, the weight, the burdens, everything was just, it was just lifted. Broken. Everything just fell off me. And that was like, oh Lord, going on 3 years now. And when I walked in the church, oh my God, I felt the presence of God. Amen. Like just hitting it, like just with power, you know. And the way I was feeling, the pains in my body, because I have pains all in my knees. All the pain in my knees left, everything left. I got delivered, set free, and just that Tuesday night Bible study. And I continued coming to Lonnie Christian Ministry under the leadership of Pastor Ann. On Tuesday nights, the Bible studies were so awesome. I mean, when she read from the Bible, she give us,
like knowledge and understanding. She told me, she explained it, you know, scripture by scripture, piece by piece. And that's what we know about her. She breaks it down so awesome to give us the clear understanding of the word on choosing our Bible study. But that don't stop there. I started inviting people to church. Yeah. I got my twin sister to come to church right there.
Amen.
Oh, Lord, hallelujah. When I got my daughter to come, she was living in our marriage. I got out of the projects and started moving there in with me, and really she was broken. She was crushed. Amen. She was on pills. She was messed up. I mean, totally. When Brittany walked in this church, walked up on the parking lot, and you know, it was a Sunday night or a Tuesday night,
It was for
a revival. And her came in, and I mean, it's like a big turtle. She was sitting right there, and like when the pastor started preaching and praying, and like a turtle shell just fell off her back. The turtle shell just fell off her back. Spiritually and spiritually, I seen it fell off her back. She was broken. She was crushed. She was bruised. She was lost. And I invited my daughter to come, and she's been here ever since at Anointed Christian
Ministry. Amen.
That's the one that just sung.
Amen.
And she got the church of God, the pieces that was on her body, whatever it was, the enemy or whatever, the witchcraft, whatever it was, it came off of her.
Yeah.
I told her that. Coming to Anointed Christian Ministry, though, I mean, total change. God is here.
Yes.
Healing is here.
Yes.
Deliverance is
yes.
here.
Yes.
Breakthroughs is here.
Yes.
My son, my oldest son, I got one more testimony. My son, they almost killed my son. My son was shot at, my 18-year-old son. Protection is here. My son didn't get a wound on him. Nothing, no kind of bullet hole, nothing to his vehicle. Not even to him, you know, he needs to sustain any kind of
divine protection.
But divine protection.
Yes,
man. Divine protection. And I have to say, healing is here. Deliverance is here. Protection is here. God, number one, God is here.
Amen.
Talk to her, we keep going through this, something she prayed with us.
She
prayed. She gave us encouragement. She was powerful. And she's the thing about she's specialized in spiritual warfare.
Yes.
Chop them demons in
the air.
Start at verse 6. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah.
God is good all the time. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. Glory be to God.
I give to God today.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. I gave God a back injury. I don't know if some people heard about it, but I had a back injury. And I didn't even have to have the surgery. And God blessed me with some money and bought the building. Hallelujah. But this I say, he that soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he that soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he purposeth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves the cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. You see, God will make sure that you have everything you need. That's what he's saying. Amen. Verse 9, it says, as it is written, he has dispersed abroad. He has given to the poor. His righteousness remains forever. See, God, you see, God just dispersed the money all over. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. God said, the gold and silver is his. The cattle on the silver on the thousand hills is for God. Glory be to God. Everything is for God, church. And he wants to see if he can trust you to help build his kingdom.
Amen.
Amen. And when you, like I said, if you give it to a true man or woman of God, God will.
I know that's right.
Amen. Glory be to God.
Amen.
And I have blessed hands. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And it says, now he that ministers seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food and multiply. Say multiply.
Multiply.
Your seed sown and increase the fruits of your rich of your righteousness. Being enriched to everything, to all bountifulness, which causes through us thanksgiving to God. So God will multiply your seed sown, and he will enrich you. Hallelujah, glory be to God, amen. You will prosper, amen, when you give to the house of God. Glory be to God. God said, I'm opening up the windows of heaven. Before you are blessed, you will not have room enough to receive. And God said, I'm going to rebuke the devourer. Nobody will be able to stop your way. Nobody will be able to hinder your finances if you give God news. Hallelujah. He's going to rebuke the devourer, meaning you won't get fired from your job. And if they do let you go, you're going to have another job.
Yeah!
And God is showing you where the treasures are. Amen. But sometimes we don't know where the hidden treasures are, but God knows where it is.
Amen.
He's going to make sure it gets to you.
Glory be to God.
Amen. Glory be to God. I wasn't waiting on something when I took care of some old people. The husband and wife died. God blessed me with $12,000. First they gave me $1,200, then they gave me $12,000.
Amen.
Those that want an envelope, but don't just use it for $2 or $3, please, amen. Because we got to pay for these and we're trying to do it. It costs. But amen.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. But if y'all want to put 20 or over, take the envelope, please. God bless you. Amen. Y'all want the envelope for 20 or over. God is good. If you rob God,
Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, multiply every seed that was sown, Lord. Open up the windows of heaven. Pour us out a blessing we will not have room enough to receive, and rebuke the law of our finances. Jesus, we turn 5 loaves and 2 fish, Lord, and fed 5,000 people. So God, multiply every seed that was sown. God, do a miracle in their lives, Father, in the name of Jesus. Let finances locate them, God. Father, that finances that was held up, God, let it locate them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Say, money coming.
Money coming.
Jesus'
name.
A lot of hands.